Philadelphia Eagles live to see another day. The defending Super Bowl champs came to FedEx Field with a clear mission. They had to beat the Redskins, and they needed the Chicago Bears to beat the Minnesota Vikings, and both of those things happened. Even when they were 4-6 this year, they felt like, hey, we just have to continue to trust the process, continue coming to work, trying to get better little by little, and things would fall into place. Sure enough, they won 5 of their last 6 games, and now with the help of the Chicago Bears, they're in the playoffs. Nick Foles took a shot to the ribs tonight, but he has said he's going to do everything he can to play. He's expecting to be okay. On the other side of the ball, the Washington Redskins are really pathetic into their season. They brace for what could be a very interesting offseason. From everything I understand, their head coach, Jay Gruden, will be back, but there will likely be changes on his coaching staff. It's the same tired song for the Redskins. What if, and maybe next year.
Lamar Jackson has provided quite the identity makeover for the Ravens, but this is still Baltimore, where tradition says defense wins championships. It seems fitting that in crunch time on Sunday at the big ATM, defense provided the key play that clinched the AFC North title. It also served as a reminder that if the Ravens are to beat the Chargers again in their first round playoff game and make a legitimate run at the Super Bowl, defense will be the ticket. As for Jackson, 2 more fumbles on Sunday, and it provided a big question heading into the playoffs. Is this a bad habit that is going to cost the Ravens when it matters the most? Because sometimes not even the league's best defense can bail you out.
So this was a team that was really supposed to be just one player away, just a quarterback away from competing for Super Bowls. But as we saw with the disappointing Minnesota Vikings defeat Sunday in the regular season finale against the Chicago Bears, they need a lot more help than that. And it's just hard to characterize this season as anything else but a massive failure. They signed Cousins to help the team win games just like this, but 132 passing yards and just 10 points against a very good Bears defense is still unacceptable. Head coach Mike Zimmer now has some pretty interesting decisions he needs to make this offseason, and there's no doubt that number one on that list is that offensive coordinator. Whatever the Vikings decide to do at offensive coordinator, whether it's to go in a new direction or retain Stefanski, the objective is going to be for the system and the play calling and the scheme and everything else involved to completely maximize what they can out of Kirk Cousins.